Hey guys, I'm John Pershuren, and this is the Affiliate Marketing Cookbook. Today, I'm going to show you how to build a blog. Now, I'm using ClickFunnels because I use ClickFunnels for absolutely everything. I use it for my website, my blog now, sales funnels, obviously, opt-in pages. You can use it for affiliate pages. It even has a built-in autoresponder for the Platinum package. Now, obviously, I said before, I'm going to use it to build a blog. So we're going to get right into it. I'm going to share my screen with you. So here we go. Here is the ClickFunnels. I chose a blank template for a very good reason. So I'm just going to build this all from scratch. And what I'm doing is I'm actually going to funnel hack the ClickFunnels blog, as you can see right here. And I'm going to turn it into my own. I'm not going to copy it, but I'm going to model after it. So what I'm going to do here is these green boxes are sections. The blue boxes are rows and columns, and the orange boxes are elements. So I'm going to add a new section here and see what we're trying to emulate this bar up here with the first section. So I'm going to go full width on this one, just one row. And I've actually, before I even started any of this, let's see if it shows up. I actually can't see it. Anyways, you can't see it. So I actually drafted out on a sheet of paper, just really quick. I think it took me 2 minutes, 3 minutes, what my whole blog is going to look like. So we added that first row here. Now we're going to add a new row with two columns. Oh, and I screwed that up somehow. Perfect. So take that one column and add, we'll just move that up here. There, switch those around a little bit. So inside the columns, you have elements. So I'm going to choose a new element on the left side here. I'm going to add an image because that's what they do here on their website. And then they have this little section down here. We're going to try to emulate that a little bit too. So go back here. Below the image, I'm going to add a subheadline. Below the subheadline, I'm going to add a headline. And then below that, I'm going to add a paragraph. And they also have a little button underneath there. So I'm going to add one of those as well. So scroll down a little bit here. And there's the button. Okay, so the right side, now they have that little quiz thing or whatever. So I'm going to do that too. But I'm just going to have a survey. Where is it? There it is right there. I'll just put a survey. I'm not filling any of this in or getting into any of the intricacies of it yet in this video because I just want to keep it simple and show you how to build the actual framework for a blog. Okay, so we have our first row, our first columns, and now we're going to build this part down here. So they have the general post, and you see all the general posts. So we're going to do that. Go down here, click add a new row, add a new row with one column because there's just that text in there, right? We can add, I suppose we'll just put a subheadline in there just to occupy space. We're going to add a new row. Now there are three videos in there, so we're going to do a new row with three columns. And then we're just going to do the same thing as we did here. The element on the left side here, we're going to put an image. Below the image, we put a subheadline. Below the subheadline, a headline. And below the headline, a paragraph. And then, of course, they have that little button on the bottom. So we'll hit that and add a little button. Perfect. So I'm not sure how many of these rows I'm going to have, how many different types of videos I'm, or excuse me, blog posts I'm going to have, but I'm going to demo at least three of them. So I'm going to follow the same format all the way down. If you go right here, those two sheets of paper, you can actually clone your sections, your whole section. So you click that, boom, there's another one. I'm going to add at least three, so boom, we'll click that and have another one. And then I suppose I could have done that with the sections too. Okay, well, we'll just add another row, one column right there in between. Perfect. See how easy this is with ClickFunnels? It looks a lot harder than it is once you first start out, but once you actually get to playing with it and building stuff, it's super simple and it'll save you so much time. So after having that all done, we will move on. Move on all the way down. Perfect. That's exactly where I wanted to be. Now I'm going to have something like this on this left side. I'm not going to fill it all out right now, obviously. It'll take way too much time. The principle of the matter is we want a new row with two columns. The right side, I'm putting a checklist in there, bullet list. The left side, I'm going to have headline and a button. That's what I have for now. Everything else I'll kind of put in there later once I actually fine tune this. And then on the bottom, the very bottom, we're going to have the contact me and your logo. So we'll put one more row of two. Okay. So then you'll have your it won't be a headline, but it'll be like your contact information, site navigation, about us, whatever you have that you want to add down there. That's all up to you. And the right side, we're going to have a logo. So for now, we'll just pop another image in there. Cool. So that's it. All right. That's all. So I hope you found this extremely valuable, or at least a little valuable. If you are interested in trying ClickFunnels, I'm going to leave a link for a 14-day free trial in there for you. I'm also going to leave a link for my free one-pager, 7 Steps to Skyrocket Your Sales, as my gift to you. I'm also going to leave a link to my Facebook group, The Affiliate Marketing Cookbook, and a link to my podcast, The Affiliate Marketing Cookbook. So I hope you found this extremely valuable. Please like my videos, subscribe to my channel, and I will see you guys later.